Welcome back. Well, it's a challenge to entertain in your own home. You have to decide what to cook, how much to spend. Alexandra Kovach has all the answers. The Washingtonian bride and groom voted her one of the top wedding planners, and she's going to help turn our parties from drab into fab.
That's right.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Help us out. Help us be fiscally responsible yet entertaining.
It's very fun to throw a party, but you can't let it turn into a stressful occasion for you. First thing to do is plan ahead and set the stage. So think about what decor you're going to have. We would do flowers. Now, flower arrangements can be a little pricier.
Sure.
You can also opt for a bowl of apples, which are beautiful and inexpensive. If you pair them with a sangria, you can put the apples in the sangria. You can pair it all together.
Now, do you leave it as a decoration, or do you allow your guests to eat
it? You may find that they will dig in, which is fine. But typically, it's a centerpiece, and you can use that just for decor throughout the room.
And one of your tips was go with the flow. So if you plan it just as decoration and they start eating it, don't go off.
You have to just let them. You got to roll with it.
Okay.
Right, right. You have to let them do that.
Now, you were saying, get rid of the chips and dip.
Yeah, class it up a little bit.
It's
not difficult. And you know, they're tasty, but go for the healthier options too. People are more conscious of what they're eating right now. So you can take it up a notch, class it up, use glassware instead of disposables too. You know, mix and match. You can go to a local store, they're having a sale, maybe a dollar a glass, and it's a little more festive and you feel like you're entertaining in your home and not just having a backyard barbecue if you're in your living room.
What kind of parties do you do this for? Is it baby showers, wedding showers, just the 4th of July barbecue? Does it apply to all kinds
anything.
Of
anything. A simple dinner party. We put fruit in centerpieces in weddings even. All these rules would apply to any kind of party you'd like to have.
Now you're saying dinner party. Do you have a sit down? Or do you do family style buffet?
You can do anything you'd like. Family style buffet, those are interactive, so guests will be a little more comfortable. They can chat while they're passing things, or you know, building tacos from a taco bar, or building their own sushi. You could do a crepe party, and you know, all these different themes you can apply.
So what are the few things that we have here? It looks pretty healthy.
So this is a Spanish kind of theme for a sangria, a nice little sangria for the summer, but maybe for a World Cup party for Spain.
Very good.
We've opted out of chips, and we have some manchego cheese, some cherry peppers with goat cheese, so you can buy those prepared at the store and then just stuff them with goat cheese yourself. A very simple option that looks delicious and look like you put a lot of work into it.
Fancy, like,
but
you didn't.
You could just chop up all the fruit in your fridge and put it in some wine and a little liqueur overnight, and you have an instant sangria.
And what are those right there? Are they almonds?
Yes, those are Marcona almonds, also Spanish almond.
And they're glazed?
They're in olive oil.
Ooh.
Yeah. So delicious and healthy. Snacking like chips, but not opting for the chip and dip.
Now, Natasha will tell you, I base a lot of my life on the Real Housewives series on Bravo. And on New York, Sonia comes to her parties about 10 minutes late.
Yes.
Is that not good?
You know, I like to tell the hostess to be ready. It's nice if people arrive that you're greeting them rather than you making an entrance to your own party. So, but you also want to be calm and relaxed and enjoying yourself at the same time. You don't want to be stressed out. So you don't want to be in your bathrobe cooking when the doorbell rings. But it's really important that you enjoy your own party, because no one else will if you don't. And I see it with whether you're a bride or you're throwing a dinner party. It's not fun to be stressed. It just makes everyone else stressed.
Well, that's the thing. How do you not be stressed? I mean, you're in charge of the whole thing. When people leave, they're like, that wasn't very well organized.
Well, if you plan ahead, they won't say that. And they'll just say, we had a great time. Now, you can plan everything you want. You can make playlists. You can, you know, on your iPod, you can plan ahead. And something's going to happen. They're not going to dance. Or they're not going to play the games you arrange for them. But you know what? They're having a great time. You just let it go. You can't force people to take a direction that they're not taking.
That's an interesting point, games, because some people hate them and some people love them.
Right.
Where do you have parties? Do you just do them for showers, or games just for showers?
Well, sometimes a dinner party can end in a, you know, game of Pictionary or a Trivial Pursuit. It depends on your crowd. You have to be able to read your crowd, and you know your friends. But if they're not going to go play the game, you don't want to force them to do that, because then they'll remember your party in, you know, in not a positive way.
And what do you do, especially now, like if you had a party this weekend, it's so hot out. Do you plan outdoor parties for this time of year?
Well, you do, and if you have some weather affecting your party, you know, that can make it a memorable experience. If you have a huge thunderstorm that comes in the middle of your party, you know, it actually can end up being a very bonding memory for all of your guests, too. So you never know. It's a little stressful, but if you can get through it, they don't last for that long, and then you can have a nice evening.
So you should have a backup,
though. You always have a backup plan.
Do you need a tent, or do you, can you just
Well, it depends on your environment, but it's a good idea. You know, but I've had parties where you don't want to put 250 people in a tent when there's an electrical storm on its way.
Oh, no, that's, you know, that's probably the best tip you've said.
Even your rain plans need a backup plan sometimes.
All right, we're going to need to talk about what is in this drink.
Right. So
this, I've been waiting for my alcohol episode.
This is a rosé sangria. Okay. It has the Spanish version of Cointreau, which is called Liquor 43. And that's, so it's a real Spanish sangria, and it has cantaloupe, peaches, and strawberries, and rosé wine, and a little spritzer, and then a few little secret ingredients in there, too.
Now, my producer says that I'm allowed to drink, even though it's not even noon yet, so.
Well, I made a breakfasty version.
So thank you very much for coming
on. Thank you for having me. Cheers.
Mm. Oh, my goodness. All right, coming up.